Thank you all. I am Jeff Johnson. I'm seeking your endorsement for governor. I will abide by your endorsement for governor because I think it ought to matter, and I believe it's our best path forward in November. And I want to talk to you about a dilemma we have in the party right now, because I hear this from so many of you. I like multiple candidates in this race. I can't decide who to pick. I hear that a lot. And heck, I like multiple candidates in this race. I just like me better. But it's a good dilemma, but it is a dilemma because we only get to pick one in the end. And I want to tell you why I think I should be that one candidate that we end up picking. And it's pretty straightforward. I believe I'm the endorsable conservative in the race who can actually win statewide against Mark Dayton. So let's start with the endorsable piece. I think most of us are looking for something pretty similar when we endorse a candidate. We want an unwavering conservative who isn't afraid of a fight. And that's my record. I'm an unapologetic fiscal and social conservative. I tell people not in an obnoxious or angry sort of way, but more in a Norwegian Lutheran from northern Minnesota sort of a way, which doesn't hurt in Minnesota. And I have never shied from a fight. I might not be the biggest guy in the race, I might not be the loudest guy in the race, I might not have the most one-liners, but you will not find a more tenacious or a scrappier fighter in a lot of us. And you can see that if you look at my 6 years in the Minnesota House, but probably more clearly the last 5.5 years as the often lonely conservative on the Hennepin County Board in the heart of the left-wing beast. And whether I am fighting the latest property tax increase, or the latest light rail, or now streetcar boondoggle, or forcing them finally after 30 years to take down the UN flag from outside the Hennepin County Government Center, I will never shy from a fight. And you'll see that same fight for me as your governor. For example, I will fight every single day to make Minnesota's business climate actually competitive with the states that surround us. And we will welcome entrepreneurs back to Minnesota, and we'll celebrate people who are successful rather than denigrate them. And I will take head-on the shameful education achievement gap in this state between white students and students of color, and we will do that by creating a rather public debate, maybe battle, with the teachers union and with the education establishment about real school choice for every parent in this state. And as a dad, I got two boys. Thor's in high school, Rolf is in middle school. I will make this promise to you. I will never, ever let them throw our kids under a school bus for some agenda like Common Core or a so-called bullying bill. Enough is enough. And finally, I will continue to fight every single day government's never-ending attempts to control our lives, where we live, how we travel, what we do with our own property, how we raise our kids, what we eat, what we drink. I've got a 12-year-old at home who doesn't need a nanny anymore, and neither does anyone else in this room, and I think it's high time we had a governor who tells bureaucrats and legislators to mind their own damn business and get out of ours. Enough is enough. I sometimes have people ask me whether I have anything in common with Mark Dayton, and I say, sure, we both want to control my life. So some things are worth a fight, but none of that matters. None of that matters if we can't win. We have to win. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but while Mark Dayton seems to be trying his very hardest, he's also the most incompetent governor in the United States of America, and we have to beat him in November. And for Republicans in a state like Minnesota to beat an incumbent, an entrenched incumbent, we can't just say we're going to pick a good solid conservative and we're good to go. That's not enough. We've got to pick a good solid conservative who can actually convince non-Republicans in every region of the state to pick us over all the promises that they're going to get from Mark Dayton and the Democrats. If we pick a candidate who is perceived as the suburban guy, we will lose. If we pick a candidate who is perceived as the rural guy, we will lose. We need a statewide candidate. I spent the first half of my life in rural Minnesota. I've spent this last half in the suburbs. I have won twice big in Hennepin County despite my conservative record. And as a Hennepin County commissioner, I am in Minneapolis every single week for the last 5.5 years trying to apply our conservative principles to some very vexing problems they have there. Not as a candidate asking for their vote, but as a fresh perspective trying to help them solve problems, and we have to pick someone who can do at least a little bit better in the urban core if we want to win statewide. So if you are looking for a true conservative who can actually win, If someone who's a scrappy little fighter but has that Scandinavian demeanor that won't scare away independence, then I just ask that you give me a really close look, because I think I might be your guy, and I would be truly honored to earn your support. So thank you for everything you do. Have a great convention today.